Hey everybody, Easy Badfish here, and welcome back to Digging In. This is episode number 2, and as you can see, it's still nighttime outside of our little cave here. It's basically right after where I stopped last time. I thought, you know, I really need to go down in this cave and do some stuff. I could maybe work on the farm and stuff off camera and come back and show them updates. But I mean, this is still survival Minecraft. This is still early on game. I don't have anything. I don't even have any more food at the moment. So spending a whole lot of time in the cave is kind of out of the question. I can't really go outside right now because there's all kinds of monsters. So I think what we're going to do is we're just going to poke our head into this little cave system here and hope that and just hope that it's okay. We'll spend a little bit of time in here lighten this area up, but then other than that, I think, yeah, see, there's not even anything here. Other than that, we'll run back outside and then get a little bit more of a better farm going and definitely explore around the area so we get an idea of our surroundings. So let's move on with that then. What's the best way to, I guess, like that. All right. And of course, we'll have to reel up this staircase and make it an actual staircase in a second. Oops. All right. Sorry about that. I had to grab my headphones. I'm like, why can't I not hear anything? Same as yesterday. Remember that? I was like, my game sounds aren't on. Oh, it's because my headphones are muted. They're it's a nice set of headphones, and it's plugged. My speakers are actually pretty nice too. And the speakers have a knob that kind of sits on the desk with a really sensitive button on it. Man, is this it? This can't be it. I'll bet you that if we dig around here, we'll break into another cave somewhere. Man, that kind of stinks. I was hoping for a little bit bigger of a cave here. That's right. This was not meant to be our house or anything like that. We're just holding up here to get a few basic things. Everything we're doing right now is temporary. That's why I don't want to like cut out this huge room and, you know, start building all kinds of crazy doors and stuff in here. Yeah, we don't need any of that. I bet we're even going to cut out the cobblestone that we put to a block off the doorway when we leave, but we are just going to grab these resources here. I'm almost positive there's another cave. I just heard a bat. I don't hear him now, but I don't see a bat. Let's poke around a bit. Yeah, I don't know if you can hear that. There's definitely bats around here. What's up with the block lag on a single player, man? See, look at that. What's going on with that? Yeah, I'm in a taiga. I'm not in, like, extreme hills or anything. Oh, baby. And, in case you were curious, the extreme hills bit is because, when you're in extreme hills, that's where silverfish can spawn. And silverfish are inside of blocks, and, they're called monster blocks. And they will, yeah, see? Bats. I knew it. I knew there was stuff down here. Let's light this bad boy up. Man, no monsters. I guess it hasn't been loaded that long, and I've been close by enough that maybe stuff just didn't spawn in here? I don't know. Oh, that bat scared me. I just accidentally planted a torch. Hello, creep it. Whoop. Back up. Fight the creeper. I hear. I heard a zombie villager and I didn't want to get too close to over here. Man, he's loud. Well, he's up there. He's everywhere. Alright, well, let's grab some of this iron. Man, he's sounds really close. That's why I ran back into that creeper, man, because I thought he was right behind me. Anything around this corner that I should worry about? Actually, does this go anywhere? And I'm out of torches. Well, not completely. I can make a couple more. And I might as well. Maybe not. Maybe not all of it. You never know. I mean, I guess I have other logs, so it's not that big of a deal, but... Yep, this cave looks like it goes for quite a bit. There's tons of bats in here. So yeah, like I said, I don't want to spend too much time in this cave right now. I just wanted to poke in, grab some iron and stuff. So we're gonna grab this. We'll head back up to the surface because it might be daytime. I don't have a clock yet, and that's something that I pretty much always have. If you watch my Groovalicious series, you might notice that I pretty much always have a clock in my hotbar, and that is because I like to know what time of day it is. In real life, if I don't have access to a clock, I start getting anxiety. I don't necessarily need to always know exactly what time it is, but I do need to have the option to be able to tell. Otherwise, I start getting really nervous for some reason. I don't really know why. But I guess that's carried over into Minecraft also. So, I'm not getting, like, anxiety over it or anything, but I really, really wish that I had. See, this guy spawned. Did he spawn in here? Oh, running away. Is that iron in the? Dang it! There's iron up there. All right. I'm gonna die. I have to leave. It's all right. We can come back for this stuff later. This was obviously not the correct way to go. But we can grab this iron too. Oh, yeah, it was. Sweet. Yeah, I knew this cave was bigger. Oh. All right, we're back on the surface, and I managed to get 34 iron out of that, so not pretty bad for just a quick little stick our head in and see what's down there. It is daytime, luckily, so we can get back outside and get a look at our food situation. That is really dangerous. Having a ledge like that, there could be creepers and stuff up there just waiting for me to come outside and blow me up. And I am really close to death. We have 4 hearts left. I need to get some food, man. Where's my, it's right here. I could kill some of these chickens, but I don't think I need to. I think there's more over this way. We need some food. Hello, chickens. I want to just get enough food so that I'm not dying. Because I want to get up in this taiga, and I want to kind of explore the area around me. You know, not necessarily because I want to do anything with it right away, but, you know, I need to know where stuff is at. See what's around us. Maybe there's something interesting. Maybe we'll get lucky and find a village. A spruce village. That would be awesome. I'm gonna need another furnace so we can cook up some of this food. Get that going. Alright, let's get a little bit organized here. I need a chest of some description. Now, I don't want to have too much stuff here, because again, this is just a temporary. I'm not even gonna make this like, I don't know, a hidey hole, whatever you want to call it. This is not a permanent dwelling of any kind, is what I'm getting at. Let's make, iron helmet. That's fun. Is my food done? Food is done. Let's eat it and get out of here. Hopefully we can get some more while we're out. I mean, I'm sure we will. All right. I think the first thing we should do is just get up to the top of this hill and see what we can see. So I don't know. I honestly don't know the difference between Taiga and Mega Taiga. I know that Podzol is only in Mega Taiga, so that is what I want, obviously. But what is this, like, way over there? They see more spruce trees. So there's nothing really to see, I guess, from this vantage point. Man, I let the day... It got day early while I was down there. See what I mean? That's why I need to have a clock. Because without a clock, I have no idea. I wasted half a day down in there. I see more chickens. I want to leave these pigs. Because, ooh, that's good. You see that? Pumpkin. I definitely want to leave the pigs because I don't have a pig farm at the moment. Pig pen. Ooh, and cows over there. That's good. So we got some animals around. The cows are good because we're gonna have wheat here really soon once the once all that stuff grows. So we'll be able to get those guys back to base and get a cow pen going pretty easily. And since we're playing on actual vanilla 1.11, maxinity cramming is set to default, so that means we're at 24, which means I can make one of those super easy cow farms and not have to worry about the stupid babies growing up and glitching through stuff. I don't know if you know about that, but that is a super annoying problem that I have. As far as cow farms go, I've never had one that just really works that well. So, just because the babies, they grow up and glitch through everything. Doesn't matter what it is. Let's jump up over here, because it looks like I saw Extreme Hills. Pretty sure. Yeah, that looks like it's, well, I don't know. Maybe. But I do not believe this is a Mega Taiga. Yeah, we're just in a regular Taiga still, so... That's not as cool as I was hoping for, but, you know. There's plenty of caves and stuff around. There's plenty of stuff to see. I am running low on food already. Let me get my shovel out. So I can actually navigate this... Oh, sun is going down already, man. I guess we're going to end up back in that cave. Maybe. I don't know. I guess I could be using this time to actually light up my base. But I really wanted to see what was over here. More caves. This taiga just goes to about here. Not the biggest taiga biome. Not the coolest looking one either. That's all right. I mean, we don't even have to settle here. This is just, night was coming, I found a cave, and there we go. That's the only reason that we're even over here. Well, that and, the taiga. I really want to build the taiga base. Alright, I guess we need to head back. We need to start working our way back to base. We didn't get very far, and that's my fault. Because of the daylight thing. Not knowing what time of day it was. Oh man, am I even going to make it back before it gets dark? Are my crops even grown? Is there any more chickens to slaughter? Probably not if I go back the way that I came, but fortunately, that's the best way to do things. There are so many pigs, though. I mean, I don't even have carrots right now. And I am pretty desperate for food, so... I'm sure that by the time I have carrots, more will be have spawned. Oh man, I really need to get back home. But pigs everywhere. Kill all the piggies. I need your bacon. Give me bacon. Actually, it's pork chops, man. Bacon's alright, but, it's all about the pork chops. Please don't leave comments hating on me because I said that. Bacon is good. Wow, it's a skeleton party over by the chicken pen. Yeah, I really need to light this place up. That's a lot of skeletons, yo. Do I even have a shield? I don't, but I have iron now, so I can make one. Well, I had cut because I thought, you know, maybe I'll just sit here and finish cooking up all my food and stuff, and then and organize some things, and then maybe it'll be daytime, we can go out and see. But, yeah, I've been sitting here for a few minutes, and I'm starting to get antsy, so I figured, you know what? I just made a full suit of iron armor. I have a shield that I should equip. I'm confident that, well, I mean, I can hear, saying that I can hear a freaking skeleton real close to me, but, yeah, I'm feeling a little good, so, I do kind of want to poke my head out, make sure there's nothing going to kill me immediately. Yeah. Alright. So there's nothing in the immediate area. I think the skeletons either wandered away or they despawned or something. Yep, there's one up there. I don't actually have a bow yet, so... I can't fight anything at range. I have to get right up on it. That skeleton or zombies are tracking me now, which is fine. I can take out some zombies. Just want to light up the area a little bit. Especially near the crops, which are still not growing. Crops take a long time to grow in this game. I don't know if you knew that, but like, it takes a long time. You know, once you kind of are established and you've got, and you've got a big wheat farm, you probably don't even notice because there's always something to harvest. But when you've only got a few pieces, you really notice how long it takes for crops to grow. Like, for instance, those crops were planted the first Minecraft day before it got night for the first time, and this is going to be the third sunrise. Or the second sunrise since these were planted, and I still have not got a full one. And I know you have to be next to them, which is something else I disagree with. I think the chunks should just have to be loaded. I mean, I know that they did it that way so that, you know, people like to build big, especially on SMP servers, people like to build big old, you know, vegetable farms at their spawn. And, spawn chunks are always loaded, so if you've got a bunch of big vegetable farms at spawn, your whole server is going to be laggy because those farms are always loaded, or those chunks are always loaded, which would mean the farms are always growing. But the flip side to that is, I mean, I basically have to stand next to these stupid crops for them to grow, or be within the area, and I don't exactly know how close it is, but yeah, once I get too far away, they stop growing. Just kind of like how mobs will stop walking if you get too far away from them. It's just a way to save lag. So, alright. So we got that going on. It's daytime again, finally, so why don't we... I have a bit more food on me. Let's kind of go off in this direction, because I want to check out this taiga that's over here. I'm still kind of looking for that perfect spot. This one attracted my attention right away because it was the taiga next to some plains. There's this flower forest here. But then, you know, after exploring it a little bit, I was a little less enthusiastic about it. So I'm really still looking for that perfect spot. And I'd love to find just a massive taiga that goes into a mega taiga. Something like that. So, we'll go and see what's over here. Come around the corner and what do I see? Three little sheepies staring at me. Oh, man. No more nighttime for us, boys. And there's extra sheep here, too, so I don't even have to feel as bad about slaughtering all of them. Because I don't have... I mean, I guess I could have brought shears. But, I wasn't planning on it. Alright, one more and we'll be able to make a bed. Sweet! Yeah, this flower forest is way bigger than I originally thought it was. I thought it was just this little section out here, but it kind of goes in a strip all the way through here, and it looks like up even maybe over this hilltop. But I mean, it just seems to be like a strip through the middle of these other biomes, which I think is kind of neat. I kind of want to see if it keeps going or what. Yeah, Flower Forest is good. That's a pretty good find early on. That's lots of dye, and I like the dye stuff. Yeah, man, this just goes. That's pretty cool. Well, unfortunately, made it through the taiga, which is not as cool. Good lord! This is the biggest flower forest I think I've ever seen. It's just absolutely massive. Does it stop? I mean, I'm sure it does eventually, but that's just a massive flower forest. Alright, let's see how far this taiga goes. It doesn't seem to be a very deep taiga, but it looks like it might be long. Ooh. Not the best ravine ever, to be honest with you. It's not very deep. It's pretty small, but there's probably some good amount of resources we can get out of there, especially to start with. Hey, here's a question. Does anybody else notice that when it goes midday and you're playing, that the game seems to get darker? Does that happen for anybody else? Like, I'll be running around, and this happens to you guys. You guys, I found a spruce village. Oh, man, I'm pretty. Holy cow, the villager sounds. There's a lot of them. Let's see what we got. Nitwit, very nice. What are you, librarian? What do you have? Blast protection, not great. But, come on. Let's close them in. We are definitely going to have to remember that this is here. So, excuse me, sir, what do you have? Silk touch for 16. That is epic, dude. We need to save him. Excuse me, sir. Are you the same guy? You're not. Frostwalker 2 for 36. That's not... I don't care about that at all. You know what? That's not gonna work. I don't have enough stuff. Okay. Well, we have two options. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm going to try and save up as many of these guys as I can. But there's so many, and they're all hanging out outside of the buildings and stuff. There's a lot of librarians. There's a lot of nitwits, too. That actually kind of stinks. Ooh, a blacksmith. What do we got? Anything good? Oh, man! Obsidian, diamonds, iron stuff. Oh, I wish I'd found this earlier. Could have saved on some of that iron, but that's good to have backups like that. Anything in the furnaces? Nope. Just took all your stuff. Sorry, boys. Man, we're going to be able to get into the nether right away. Anything good here? Carrots. Carrots, 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 carrots. Do you got carrots? You got carrots? What is this? Potatoes. Potatoes, okay. No carrots, though. Dang it, man. Why don't you have carrots? Don't you see, villagers, that you're surrounded by pigs? You should have carrots. I'm serious. Well, unfortunately, we only got that one guy in there. I don't know what he's got. There's two freaking librarians here. Silk Touch for 25. Frostwalker for 36. Where'd the Silk Touch for 16 go? Man, I really hope these villagers are going to be okay. What do you have? Fire protection for 14. I mean, you never know what else he's got. Could be something good. In case you're curious what I'm doing. Villages on hard mode suffer from a problem called zombie sieges, which basically means it is what it sounds like. A bunch of zombies will spawn and will start killing the villagers. So what I'm trying to do is basically block them into their houses so that they are safe. But unfortunately, they're all just kind of hanging out all over the place. There's another farm. There's a bunch of wheat and stuff here, but... What do you have? Ooh, a cartographer. Hello, Mr. Man. Oh, another cartographer. Well... How would you like to join your friend inside the nice World of Cartographer building? That's what we're going to call it. World of Cartographer building. wrong. There we go. Now, what you might not know is that zombies... I would just build something really quick. On an inside corner like this, where... Look here. If there is a zombie standing here, and a villager standing here, this zombie will be able to kill this villager. So when you got inside corners like this, that's bad. You need full on protection. So now, any villager standing here will be protected from zombies outside. Obviously, there's the open area behind them, but you get what I'm saying. So that's why I'm doing a full 3 blocks across the front of the door, instead of just, you know... putting the blocks directly in front of the door, because if the stupid villagers decide to try to open the door and get out while there's zombies outside, they will basically get killed because the zombies will be able to attack them. Alright, so this is not a Mega Taiga, which is unfortunate, but that is another village over there. Nice. Okay, so we got tool villages. Alright, we need to get the crap out of here. The sun is going down. We need to leave right now. We need to leave because I didn't get a chance to block this all off, so these villagers are in a lot of danger because I am here. If I get out of here and unload the chunks, basically no zombies are going to spawn there while I'm gone. If I get far enough away, it'll be okay. Alright guys, I'm back, and I had come outside to kill that spider that we had just seen as we pulled up in the boat, but he has despawned, and I don't know where he went. That creeper was not there a few minutes ago. Let me tell you what I did, okay? I slept to make it daytime, and I came out, and pretty much all the monsters were gone. You remember there's a zombie chasing us? He's gone. That creeper that was over here, he was there. I killed him, but that's... The spider was gone. There was a skeleton in this water. I killed it, came back over here, planted some more wheat, and now there's a creeper there. So I don't understand where this creeper came from. He was not here a second ago. So yeah, monsters despawning when they shouldn't and spawning when they shouldn't. I don't know if that's just unusual coincidence. It does seem like there's a... Like... mobs spawn differently now. Like none of these creatures were here. These cows were not here. There's a bunch of horses here now. There's a ton of chickens here now. So I don't know what's going on with that. I thought that basically passive mobs or friendly mobs, whatever these are called, the spawn rates were pretty low. So the fact that there's all these animals here now is kind of strange to me. So yeah, that's a little weird. But yeah, unfortunately we did not find a Mega Taiga today. Hopefully we'll find one soon. I'll do a little bit more exploring off camera. The spruce taiga, I keep wanting to call it a spruce forest because I think that's what it used to be called, maybe. I don't know. But this taiga wraps around a little bit more. So who knows, maybe there's a Mega Taiga over in that direction. We'll go, I'll do some more exploring off camera. And hopefully we'll have something interesting when we come back. But we did do a bit of exploring today. We found 2 villages. We cleared out part of this cave. And there's still plenty more in that to go. So more resources to collect for us. But I'll probably do most of that stuff off camera, because that is all the time I have for recording this video. So if you guys liked it, maybe leave it a like. If you got a comment, especially if you know anything about the mob spawning now, that the friendly / passive mob spawning, that it seems that it's been turned up. I did not do anything. This is just a standard single-player world. But yeah, I guess that's it for today. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye-bye.